أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وهو الذي أنشأ لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة. And it is he, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has created for you the hearing and the sight, and bestowed upon you the faculty of inferring and reasoning. قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ. But there is very little thanks that you give to him. وَهُوَ الَّذِي ذَرَعَكُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. And it is he who has scattered you in this world, and he will gather you again. Who can scatter can gather also. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ. And it is he who gives life and then causes death. وَلَهُ اخْتِلَافُ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ. And to him belongs this system of alternation of night and day. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. So don't you understand? بَلْ قَالُوا مِثْلَ مَا قَالَ الْأَوَّلُونَ. Nay, they are also saying the same which the ancients used to say. What was that? قَالُوا أَيْذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِزَامًا. Then we are dead and we become bones and dust. أَيْنَّا لَمَبْعُثُونَ. Are we going to be resurrected, created again? لَقَدْ وَعِدْنَا نَحْنُ وَآبَاؤُنَا هَذَا مِنْ قَبْلُ. These promises were given to us also and to our forefathers also. إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. But this is nothing but the stories and fables of the ancients. قُلْ لِمَنِ الْأَرْضِ. Now these few ayat which are now coming, they tell us what was the belief of the mushrikeen of Arab. They believed that the creator is Allah, none else. But Allah has subordinate gods with him, that's all, who will intercede on our behalf on the day of judgment. هَؤُلَاءِ شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. They are intercessors for us. قُلْ لِمَنِ الْأَرْضُ وَمَنْ فِيهَا. Ask them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to whom belongs this this earth and whatever is in it. إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. If you know, give the answer. سَيَقُولُونَ لِلَّهِ. They will say, they belong to Allah. قُلَ فَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Then say to them, then why don't you get admonished? قُلْ مَنْ رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ السَّبْعِ وَرَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ. Ask them, who is the Lord of the seven heavens, or the Lord of the mighty throne? سَيَقُولُونَ لِلَّهِ. Again they will say, Allah. قُلَ فَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Then tell them, don't you fear him? قُلْ مَنْ بَيَدِهِ مَلَكُوتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Ask them, in whose hands is the sovereignty of everything? وَهُوَ يُجِيرُ. And he can give protection. وَلَا يُجَارُ عَلَيْهِ. And nobody can give protection against him. إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. Give the reply if you know. سَيَقُولُونَ لِلَّهِ. Again they will say, this is for Allah. قُلْ فَأَنَّا تُسْحَرُونَ. Say to them then, where from are you being bewitched? بَلْ أَتَيْنَاهُمْ بِالْحَقِّ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ. The truth is that we have brought to them the truth, but they are liars. مَتَّخَذُ اللَّهُ مِنْ وَلَدٍ. Allah did not take to himself any son. or any daughter. وَمَا كَانَ مَعَهُ مِنْ إِلَٰهِ. And there is no God with him. إِذَا لَذَهَبَ كُلُّ إِلَٰهٍ بِمَا خَلَقَ. Then all the gods will have taken away their creations. وَلَا عَلَىٰ بَعْضُهُمْ وَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ. And some of them might have come up, stand up in revolt against the others. Subhanallahi amma yasifun. Allah is glorified from all those things which they are describing. Alim al-ghayb wa shahada. He knows what is in the unseen and what is present before the eyes. Fata'ala amma yushrikun. He is exalted very high above all those things whom they associate with him. قُلْ رَبِّ إِمَّا تُرَيَنِّي مَا يُوَعَدُونَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say to your Lord, O my Lord, if you show me what you are promising to them, the chastisement, the azab, if it comes in my lifetime, if before my own eyes this chastisement comes, رَبِّ فَلَا تَجْعَلِّي فِي الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. So my Lord, please don't include me with these evildoers. They are my kith and kin, okay. I am also a Qarshi, but I don't associate with you, anyone. وَإِنَّا عَلَىٰ أَن نُرِيَكَ مَا نَعِدُهُمْ لَقَادِرُونَ. And O Muhammad, we are very powerful. We are able to show you what we are promising them. اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي أَحْسَنَ السَّيِّئَةِ. Repel evil in the best way. نَحْنُ عَالَمُ بِمَا يَسِفُونَ. We very well know what they are describing about us. وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ هَمَزَاتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. And say, my Lord, I seek your refuge from the evil instigations of the Satans. وَعَوْذُ بِكَ رَبِّيَنْ يَحْضُرُونَ. And I seek your refuge that they should come to me. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ عَدَمُ الْمَوْتِ. Until that, when death comes to some of them, قَوَادَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ. He will say, oh my Lord, just return me, send me back. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ. Maybe that I can do charity, I can give away everything which I had left behind in charity. I will give everything. Kalla, no. Innaha kalimatun huwa qailuha. It's just a word that is coming out of his mouth. He doesn't mean it. If he is returned, he will do the same, which he had been doing before his death. Wa min waraihim barzakhun ila yawmi yub'asoon. And then in front of them will be an intermediary world till the day when they will be resurrected. This is called barzakh. Barzakh is something in between the two. فَإِذَا نُفِقَ فِي السُّورِ. So when the trumpet will be blown, فَلَا أَنْسَابَ بَيْنَهُمْ. No ties of kinship will be of any avail on that day. وَلَا يَتَسَأَلُونَ. And nobody will ask anybody else how you are. فَمَنْ سَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. So only those whose scales of good deeds will be heavy, so they will be the prosperous ones, the successful ones. وَمَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ. And those whose scales of good deeds will be light, فَأُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ فِي جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدُونَ. So they are those who have done loss to themselves, and they will then abide in the hell. تَلْفَعُ وُجُوهَهُمُ النَّارِ. The fire of hell will scorch their faces. وَهُمْ فِيهَا كَالِحُونَ. And they will be disfigured, you know. Their faces will be disfigured. أَلَمْ تَكُنْ آيَاتِي تُتْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ. Allah will ask, were not my revelations narrated to you, recited to you? فَكُنْتُمْ بِهَا تُكَذِّبُونَ. But you kept on denying them, refusing to accept them. قَالُوا رَبَّنَا غَلَبَتْ عَلَيْنَا شِقْوَتُنَا. وكنا قوما ضالين. They will say, Our Lord, our wretchedness overcame us. And we admit that we were the evil doers. ربنا أخرجنا منها. Our Lord, take us out from this at least once. فإن عدنا فإنا ظالمون. And if we revert to the same attitude, then we shall be surely evil doers. قال اخسؤوا فيها ولا تكلمون. Allah will say, stay you into this hell with ignominy and don't address me. Don't talk to me. إنه كان فريق من عبادي. There was a group of my bondsmen. يقولون, who used to say, ربنا آمنا, our Lord, we come to believe. فاغفر لنا, so forgive us. ورحمنا, and have mercy on us. وانت خير الراحمين. And you are the most merciful than all the mercifuls. فاتخذتهم سخريا. But you took them to ridicule. You mocked on them. حتى انساكم ذكري. Till that, they just made you forget my remembrance. You were busy in mocking on them, not listening to what remembrance was coming to you. وَكُنْتُمْ مِنْهُمْ تَضْحَكُونَ. You were laughing at them. إِنِّي جَزَيْتُهُمُ الْيَوْمَ بِمَا صَبَرُوا. This day I have rewarded them for the perseverance that they showed. أَنَّهُمْ هُمُ الْفَائِزُونَ. That they are those who are successful. قَالَ كَمْ لَبِثْتُ فِي الْأَرْضِ عَدَدَ سِنِينَ. In the end Allah will ask the question. What's your opinion? How many years did you stay in the land, in the earth, in the world? قَالُوا لَبِثْنَا يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. They will say, it seems to us that we stayed there for one day, for a part of a day. فَسْأَلِ الْعَادِّينَ. So we don't know it. You ask those who keep the account. قَالَ إِنْ لَبِثْتُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Allah will say, yes, you didn't stay there, but a very little while. Maybe it was 100 years, but it's nothing. My one day is equal to your 1,000 years. So it's again a part of a day. So it was correct. You stayed a very little while. إِلَّا بِسْتُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. Would that you had known it earlier, that this world is passing, it's transitory, it's a temporary abode. We have not to live it here forever. أَفَحَسِرْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا. Did you think that we had created you in vain, without any purpose? وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And that you will not be made to return to us. فَتَعَالَ اللَّهُ الْمَلِكُ الْحَقِّ. So exalted is Allah, the true king of the universe. Now what is the reason here, the argument? Can there be any ruler or king who does not punish those who revolt against him and does not reward those who are faithful, obedient? No, there must be reward for the faithful, obedient, and punishment for those arrogant people who stand up in revolt against him. So Allah is the true ruler of this whole universe. How could it be that he would not recall you and then give good rewards to the people who believed in him, who worked for them, for him and for his deen, and punish those who were against his deen? فَتَعَالَ اللَّهُ الْمَلِكُ الْحَقِّ. So exalted is Allah, the true king. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّهُ. There's no God except him. رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْكَرِيمِ. He is the Lord of the noble throne. وَمَنْ يَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرٌ. And whosoever will call and pray with Allah another God, لَا بُرْهَانَ لَهُ بِهِ, for whom he has no argument. فَإِنَّمَا حِسَابُهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ. Surely, their reckoning is with the Lord. إنه لا يفلح الكافرون. But rest assured, such disbelievers will not be successful. وقل رب أعوذ وقل رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين. In the end, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and through Muhammad this address is for the every ummati, every believer in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, My Lord, forgive and have mercy. And definitely you are the best of the merciful. Now, as I said, we are coming to the to a very important Madani surah, and that is Surah An-Nur. Just recall, now we are having in the Mus'haf a Madani surah after 14 Makki surahs. Yunus, Hud, Yusuf, alayhi salam, Ar-Ra'd, Ibrahim, Al-Hijr, Al-Nahl, Bani Israel, Al-Kahf, Maryam, Taha, and Anbiya. And then lastly, Al-Hajj and Al-Mu'minun. We have just finished Al-Mu'minun. Now this is the surah. It comprises 9 sections. And it has, I think, nearly about 70 or 63 perhaps ayat. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سورة أنزلناها وفرضناها. This is a very strange beginning of a surah. Mostly we have been seeing either حروف مقطعات ألف لام ميم ألف لام را ألف لام ميم صاد ألف لام ميم را and so on and so forth. Or mention of the glory for Allah. Or His praise. Or some introduction of Quran. Some praise of Quran. Only a few had started absolutely without any preface. We find Surah An-Nisa and Surah Al-Ma'idah, direct address. Ya ayyuhal nas, ya ayyuhal lazina aman. But here it's very peculiar. Particularly this surah being mentioned and utilized. Suratun, and this common noun in Arabic comes for something which is very big, very high. At-tankeer lit-takhfeem, they call it. This is the rule in the Nahf grammar of Arabic. Suratun is a very grand surah, anzalnaha, which we have sent down. Wa-faradnaha, and we have enjoined upon you, prescribed upon you. You have to abide by it. Ayatun faradna anzalna fiha ayatin bayyanatin la'allakum tadhakkaroon. And we have sent down in it very clear signs and revelations so that you get the admonition. Number one straight off, az-zaniyatu waz-zani, the adulteress and the adulterer. Fajlidu kulla wahidin minhuma mi'ata jaldah. Flog each one of them 100 stripes. Wala ta'khudhukum biha ra'fatun fi dinillah. And let not tenderness for them seize you regarding the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the hadd of Allah. This has been prescribed by Allah. You have to execute. You have to flog them 100 stripes. Maybe you are feeling sympathetic towards them, but it should not come in the way these commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have to be executed. إِن كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. If you really believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day, وَلْيَشْهَدْ عَذَابَهُمَا, and their chastisement should be witnessed, طَائِفَةٌ مِّنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, by a group of the believers. They should see it with their eyes. When they are being flogged, there should be people to watch and see, so that there is terror. It becomes a deterrent for other people that this is the punishment. If I do the same, it will come to me also. And this is the philosophy of the severe punishments that are prescribed in Islam. A deterrence. And we have examples even today. Wherever these punishments are enforced, crime just evaporates. Formerly there was an example of Saudi Arabia. But now things are different there because there are a lot of immigrants over there. people having coming from all the hooks and corners of the world. But recently, now we find the same thing in Afghanistan. Even Dr. Javed Iqbal, a somewhat secular type of, you know, scholar. But when he visited Afghanistan and we came back, he addressed a meeting in Jamia Haqqaniya, Akoda Khatak, and he said, "What I have seen in Afghanistan, if this can happen in a few more Muslim countries, then the whole world will accept Islam. Yes, peace, tranquility, no fear of theft, nothing of the sort. All peace." And that is because, you know, the punishments are very severe. If you kill somebody, you will be killed. And you will be killed in the same way in which you have killed. If you are stabbed, well, they are of that person whom you have killed has the right to stab you, just as you stab the person whom you killed. الزاني لا ينكح إلا زانية أو مشركة. The adulterer should not marry except an adulteress or someone from among the mushrikeen, some woman from the associates. والزانية لا ينكحها إلا زاني أو مشرك. And the adulteress, she should not be married except by some adulterer or some mushrik male. وَحُرِّمَ ذَلِكَ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And this has been prohibited for the believers. But please note, this is a divine providence, not a law. If some woman commits adultery, and if she was unmarried, she has had the 100 stripes, then she makes tawbah. You can marry her. There's no bar. It's not law. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, He decides in His own providence that, you know, as we say, birds of the same feather flock together. So, zaniya and zanis, they will flock together. It is the natural phenomenon. They have an inclination towards each other. And you know, the people who are chaste themselves, they wouldn't like. So this is a general phenomenon, not a law of the Sharia. وَالَّذُونَ يَرْمُونَ الْمُحْصَدَاتِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَعْتُوا بِأَرْبَعَةِ شُهَدَاءَ. As for those who accuse chaste women, and then they can't bring forth four witnesses. If you blame that she has or he has committed adultery, but he cannot produce four witnesses, eyewitnesses. فَجْلَدُوهُمْ سَمَانِينَ جَلْدًا. Flog them 80 stripes. وَلَا تَقْبَلُوا لَهُمْ حَدَةٌ أَبَدًا. And then after that, never accept from them any testimony in any case. وَأُولَٰئِكَهُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. And definitely they are the transgressors. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ. Except those who repent after that, وَأَصْلَحُوا, and who have amended, and they have rectified their behavior. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُرُ الرَّحِيمُ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving and merciful. وَالَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ أَزْوَاجَهُمْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُمْ شُهَدَاءَ إِلَّا أَنفُسُهُمْ. Now there is a special case. Whosoever accuses his wife, but there is no witness except him, he has seen the wife committing adultery. Now when he has seen this with his own eyes, can he live with her now? So what to do? But he doesn't have four witnesses. What should he do? وَالَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ أَزْوَاجَهُمْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُمْ شُهَدَاءَ. And those who accuse their wives, but they don't have four witnesses. فَشَهَادَةُ أَحَدِهِمْ أَرْبَعُ شَهَدَاتٍ بِاللَّهِ. So their testimony will be equal to four testimonies if they swear by Allah. I swear by Allah, I am true. I am telling you the truth. This is the truth. إِنَّهُ لَمِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. That I am true, truthful. وَالْخَامِسَةُ. an additional five, fifth, you know, there should be أن لعنة الله عليه إن كان من الكاذبين, that if I am a liar, then the curse of Allah should come to me. Now his one testimony now is equal to four testimonies. This will be accepted. But will the woman, the wife, be given the punishment straight off? No. She will also be given a chance. وَيَدْرَوْ عَنْهَا الْعَذَابَ أَنْ تَشْهَدَ أَرْبَعَ شَهَادَاتٍ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّهُ لَمِنَ الْكَاذِبِينَ. But you know, the punishment would be removed from her if she also swears four times by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that my husband is telling a lie, he is a liar. وَالْخَامِسَةَ, and for the fifth time she should say, أَنَّ غَضَبَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهَا إِنْ كَانَ مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ, that the wrath of Allah should come to me if he is truthful. وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given this law to you, how to settle such affairs. And he is giving them to you in detail. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ تَوَّابٌ حَكِيمٌ, and verily Allah is the acceptor of repenting, and he is the wise. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ جَعُوا بِالْإِفْكِ, now there is coming a historical event. It so happened after, you know, the Prophet ﷺ and the believers were coming back from the battle of Mustalaq, Banil Mustalaq, and there was a camp at night somewhere. Hazrat Aisha, the wife of the Prophet ﷺ, radiallahu ta'ala, was with him on this journey on a separate camel. So she had some need to urinate, perhaps. So she went away from the camp. But till such time that she came back, when she came back, she found there was a necklace and it is lost. It has dropped from somewhere. She went again. And when she came back now the caravan had gone, left. She was left alone over there. But she made a very wise decision. I should not move from here. She stayed there and then, waiting for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now decides for her. There was a duty of Safwan ibn Mu'attal radiallahu anhu. He used to walk a little distance behind the caravan, main caravan, to see whether something is dropped, someone has left something, or maybe someone is sick and is not able to walk, and he's just lying down, he needs help. When he saw, you know, someone lying there, and Hazrat Aisha had gone to sleep, and her face was now uncovered. When he came, he recognized, oh, she is Aisha, the wife of Nabi, the wife of the Prophet. The words came out, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And Hazrat Aisha specifies in this hadith that Safwan recognized me because he had seen me before the commandment of hijab. The commandment of hijab, covering the faces and covering the body for women, it had come in Suratul Ahzab. And Suratul Ahzab was revealed in the fifth year after Hijra. And this incident is happening in the sixth year after Hijra. So because he had seen me before the coming down of those commandments regarding hijab, so he recognized me. But what he did, he just made his camel sit. So Hazrat Aisha mounted the camel. And then, you know, he held the rope and went towards the main caravan, main army, and met there. But Abdullah ibn Ubay, the chief of the Munafiqeen, he saw Safwan ibn Mu'attal is coming with the wife of the Prophet Aisha radiallahu ta'ala. Now he started a slander. There must have been some wrong thing. How is it possible? A male and a female alone, and they don't commit anything. Impossible. So she had not come safe. And with this started a very big campaign of slander against Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. About 1 month passed, which was very painful for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is the incident which is mentioned here. إن الذين جاءوا بالإفك عصبة منكم. Verily those who have brought forth this slander, they are a group from your among yourselves. They are Muslims. Even Abdullah ibn Ubay was also a legal Muslim. But in this thing, you know, so many mu'mineen sadiqeen, true Muslims, were also involved there. It's the weakness of human nature. You just accept something bad as if you are already, you are ready to accept whatever is coming from some other man's mouth. لَا تَحْسَبُوهُ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ. Don't think شَرٌّ لَكُمْ, that it is evil for you. بَلْ هُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. This is good for you. Because this will become the reason why these commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are being revealed to you for the future guidance. لِكُلِّ مْرَئٍ مِّنْهُمْ مَكْتَسَبَ مِنَ الْإِسْمُ. For each one of them, there will be the reward or punishment for which whatever he earned. وَالَّذِي تَوَلَّا كِبْرَهُ. And the one among them who took the bulk of it, greatest share, that was Abdullah ibn Ubay, who was the initiator. لَهُ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. For him is a very mighty chastisement. لَوْلَا سَمِعْتُمُوهُ. Why did it not happen that when you listen to it, ظَنَّ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بِأَنفُسِهِمْ خَيْرًا. The believing men and believing women should have thought well about themselves. Who was Aisha? Aisha was the wife of the Prophet. They should have said, وَقَالُوا هَذَا إِفْكٌ مُبِينٌ. It is definitely a slander. لَوْلَا جَاؤُوا عَلَيْهِ بِأَرْبَعَةِ شُهَدَاءَ. Why didn't they bring four witnesses on this? فَإِذْلَمْ يَعْتُوا بِالشُهَدَاءَ. So when they couldn't bring witnesses, فَأُولَٰئِكَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ هُمُ الْكَاذِبُونَ. So Allah holds them to be the liars. وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ. And if there was not the bounty of Allah on you and His mercy, فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ, in this world also and in the hereafter also, لَمَسَّكُمْ فِي مَا أَفَسْتُمْ فِيهَ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. Then whatever you have indulged in, it would have given you a very mighty chastisement. اِسْتَلَقَوْنَهُ بِأَلْسِنَتِكُمْ. When you were propagating it by your tongues, وَتَقُولُنَا بِأَفْوَاهِكُمْ مَا لَيْسَ لَكُمْ بِهِ عِلْمٌ. And you were saying with your mouths, for what you had no knowledge. It was mere hearsay. You listen and then you tell anybody else also, without making sure that this is correct. That is why the Prophet had said, كَفَى بِالْمَرِ كَذِبًا أَنْ يُحَدِّثَ بِكُلِّ مَا سَمِعَ. It is sufficient for a man to be declared a liar if he says whatever he listens. Whatever he listens, he should first assess whether it is correct or wrong. If it is correct, then he can do it. He can spread it further. But if it is wrong, and he is spreading, he has become an agent in the spreading of the falsehood. اِسْتَلَقَوْنَهُ بِأَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَتَقُولُنَا بِأَفْوَاهِكُمْ مَا لَيْسَ لَكُمْ بِهِ عِلْمٌ وَتَحْسَبُونَهُ هَيِّنًا. And you were thinking it's a trivial matter. وَهُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَظِيمٌ. In the sight of Allah, it is a mighty thing. وَلَوْلَا سَمِعْتُمُوهُ قُلْتُمْ. Why didn't it happen that when you listen to it, you should have said, مَا يَكُونُ لَنَا أَن نَتَكَلَّمَ بِهَذَا. It doesn't behove us that we should speak about this thing. سُبْحَانَكَ هَذَا بُهْتَانُ نَصِيمٌ. Glorified be Allah. This is definitely a mighty lie. يَعِذُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَنْ تَعُودُوا لِمِسْلِهِ أَبَدًا. Allah exhorts you not to repeat it again forever. إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are believers. فَيُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمُ الْآيَاتِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making for you His revelations clear. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ. And He is the knower, the wise. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ أَن تَشِيعَ الْفَاحِشَةُ فِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Verily those people who wish and love that indecency or its false news should spread among the Muslims, among the believers. لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. For them there will be painful chastisement in this world as well as in the hereafter. والله يعلم وانتم لا تعلمون. Verily Allah knows and you don't know. You don't know. ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته وأن الله رؤوف الرحيم. And was it not that the bounty and mercy of Allah is upon you and that Allah is gracious and merciful, you would have been lost. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان. O you who believe, don't follow the footsteps of Satan. وَمَنْ يَتَّبِعْ خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ فَإِنَّهُ يَعْمُرُ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ. Whosoever follows the footsteps of Satan, well, he is surely, he will instigate everybody to indecent things, وَالْمُنْكَرِ and abominations. وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ. And if there was the bounty of Allah and His mercy over you, مَا زَكَى مِنْكُمْ مِنْ أَحَدٍ عَبَدًا, none of you would have been able to purify his souls. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يُزَكِّي مَنْ يَشَاءَ. But Allah purifies the souls of those whom He wish. وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. And Allah is the hearer, the knower. وَلَا يَعْقَلِ أُولُو الْأَفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَنْ يُوتُوا أُولِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Now there was an incident. Unless you know that, this ayah will not be understood. There was a distant relative of Hazrat Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه, Mistah. He was also involved in this scandal. In this scandal and slander. So Hazrat Abu Bakr, he swore by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He used to help him monetarily. But when he came to know that he is also included among those people who are slandering, so he swore by Allah, now I'm not going to help you. Now Allah is saying to him, don't do this. وَلَا يَأْتَلِ الْأُولُ الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ. Those who possess bounty and abundance among you, let them not swear أَنْ يُوتُوا أُولِي الْقُرْبَى, that they will do good to their relatives or the needy or the muhajirin, those who have migrated in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mistah was also a muhajir. وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا. They should forgive and they should overlook. أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Don't you like that Allah should forgive you? On this Abu Bakr cried out, نُحِبُّ أَنْ تَغْفِرَ لَنَا رَبَّنَا. And he said, okay, I will give the kafara of this swear that I had made, and I will continue my help to Mistah. أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ. And Allah is merciful and forgiving. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ الْمُحْصَنَاتِ الْغَافِلَاتِ الْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. Verily those who accuse chaste women who have never even thought of any wicked thing from among the believing women. لُعِنِي فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. They are cursed in this world also and in the hereafter. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. For them is a very big chastisement. يَوْمَ تَشْهَدُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَلْسِنَتُهُمْ وَأَيْدِيهِمْ وَأَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. On the day when their tongues and their hands and their feet will testify against them as to what they were used to do. يَوْمَئِذٍ يُوَفِّيهِمُ اللَّهُ دِينَهُمُ الْحَقِّ. On that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them their reward, that is, the punishment in full. وَيَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ الْمُبِينَ. And they will come to know that verily Allah is the truth, total truth, and it is absolutely manifest truth. Again, that, you know, ayah, which I said, is divine providence. Allah makes these arrangements. Al-khabisatu lil-khabisin. The wicked women are for the wicked men. Al-khabisuna lil-khabisat. And wicked men are for the wicked women. Wat-tayyibatu lil-tayyibin. And good women, they are for good people, good men. Wat-tayyibuna lil-tayyibat. And good men are for the good women. أولئك مبرعون مما يقولون. They are absolutely innocent and not guilty of what they are saying. لهم مغفرة ورزق كريم. For them is the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a very generous provision. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تدخلوا بيوتا غير بيوتكم. Now there are some social teachings regarding especially the privacy of a family. So there are certain rules. If you go to visit each other, يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تدخلوا بيوتا غير بيوتكم. Oh you who believe, don't enter the houses which are not yours. حتى تستأنسوا. Until you ask the permission and you greet them with salam. وتسلموا على أهلها. ذلكم خير لكم لعلكم تذكرون. This is better for you if you can get the admonition. فإن لم تجدوا فيها أحدا, and if you don't find in it anybody, فلا تدخلوها, don't enter it. Then you know there some blame could come that there was this and this in this house and this has been stolen, don't enter. حتى يوزن لكم. But if the permission is given by the person owning that house, okay, you can enter that house. So you can enter. وَإِن قِيلَ لَكُمْ رَجِعُوا فَرْجِعُوا. And if it is said to you, go back, then go back. Now this is very important. It's a different thing that you come after taking an appointment. In that case, you must be received and entertained. But if you go and suddenly call on somebody without having any appointment, prior appointment, then it's not your right that he must receive you and he must entertain you. Maybe he is busy in something and that business for him is more important than entertaining you. So clear instructions. If it is said to them, return, go back. Who asked alakum? That is more pure for you. Wallahu bima ta'amaluna alim. And whatever you are doing, Allah knows it. ليس عليكم جناح أن تدخلوا بيوتا غير مسكونة. There is no harm upon you, no blame upon you, if you enter the house uninhabited. غير مسكونة فيها متاع لكم. There is some luggage which belongs to you, property in it. There are stores that nobody inhabits over there. Well, you can enter. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تُبْدُونَ وَمَا تُكْتُمُونَ. And Allah very well knows what you reveal and what you conceal. قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. Ask the believers, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they should lower their gaze. Now there are two sets of instructions regarding this hijab and parda and veil and satr. What part of the body has to be covered, etc., etc. The first set was revealed in Suratul Ahzab, 1 year earlier. And there Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given the instructions that if a mu'mina, a believer, believing woman, has to go out, what she should do. Now this is another step forward. Even in your homes, what are the etiquettes that have to be observed? Don't gaze on each other. Even the brothers and sisters shouldn't gaze. Your sister is also a woman, a girl. So don't gaze her. You keep your sight low. قُلِّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُلُّ مِنْ أَفْسَارِهِمْ. They should lower their gaze. وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ. And they should guard their sexual organs. ذَلِكَ أَزْكَى لَهُمْ. This is surely more pure for them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا يَصْنَعُونَ. Verily Allah knows what you are doing. وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. Now the detailed instruction is coming for the women. And say to the believing women also, يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنَّ. They should also keep their gaze low. وَيَحْفَظْنَ فُرُوجَهُنَّ. They should also guard their private parts. وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنَّ. And they should not reveal or display their adornment, إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا, except what is apparent thereof. وَلِيَدْرِبْنَ بِخُمُرِهِنَّ عَلَى جُيُوبِهِنَّ. And let them draw their scars over their bosoms. ولا يبدين زينتهن, and they should not expose their adornment and beauty. And now there's the list. Who are, you know, exempted from this? Number one, illa لبعولتهن, except for number one, their husbands. أو آبائهن, number two, their fathers, father, grandfather, and so on. أو آباء بعولتهن, or the fathers of their husbands, father-in-law, and then the grandfather-in-law. أو أبنائهن, or their sons. أو أبناء بعولتهن, or the sons of their husbands. Maybe there are sons from some former wife, they are also exempt. أو إخوانهن, or their own brothers. أو بني إخوانهن, and the sons of their brothers. أو بني أخواتهن, or the sons of their sisters. أو نسائهن, or their own women, Muslim women, not strangers. أو ما ملكت أيمانهن, or the female slaves whom their right hands possess. أو التابعين غير أولي الأربعة, or the attendants and servants who don't have any sexual desire. من الرجال, from among the men. أو الطفل الذي لم يظهر على عورات النساء, or the child who is not up till now acquainted with the secret matters of women. ولا يضربن بأرجلهن, they shouldn't strike their feet on the earth. ليعلم ما يخفين من زينتهن, so that their ornaments that they are wearing, they give voice, and the attention of the people goes towards this. فتوبوا إلى الله جميعا, and you should repent towards Allah, all of you. أيها المؤمنون, O you the believers, لعلكم تفلحون, so that they should, you should prosper and you should be successful. And wed the spouseless among you. If there is a woman, she has become widow, try to get her married again as soon as possible. In the same way, widower, a person without any wife, a young man, he is young, full, and you know, he has the sexual desire, so you should make him marry as soon as possible. وَأَنْكَهُ الْأَيَامَ مِنْكُمْ وَصْوَالِحِينَ مِنْ عِبَادِكُمْ وَإِمَائِكُمْ, and also the righteous ones from among their slaves, males or females. إِنْ يَكُونُوا فُقَرَى, if they are poor, يغنيهم الله من فضله, Allah will make them rich from His bounty. والله واسع عليم, and Allah is ample giving and knower. وليستعفف الذين لا يجدون نكاحا, as for those women who are past the age of marriage or past the age of bearing children, so these rules are somewhat, you know, loosened for them. وليستعفف الذين لا يجدون نكاحا, and let those, no, this is another subject, and let those who find not the means to marry keep chaste. If someone is poor, he can't support wife, he should wait. حَتَّى يُغْنِيهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ, till such time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes him able to support a family. وَالَّذِينَ يَبْتَغُونَ الْكِتَابَ مِمَّا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ, and from among your slaves who want to get right down for emancipation, that I will pay you 10,000 dinars. You set me free. Now there is an agreement. Now he's working hard. He's doing labor, gathering money. There is also advice to the Muslims. You should also contribute so that it becomes easy for him to get the freedom. So if he wants that he should, mukataba, this is called, that an agreement of emancipation should be concluded. فَكَاتِبُوهُمْ إِنْ عَلِمْتُمْ فِيهِمْ خَيْرًا, if you have seen in them good, that they are gentlemen, then you must enter into such agreement with them. وَآتُوهُمْ مِمَا لِلَّهِ الَّذِي آتَاكُمْ, and also give them from the wealth that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. وَلَا تُكْرِهُوا فَتَيَاتِكُمْ عَنَ الْبِغَاءِ, and don't compel your slave girls to prostitution. إِنْ أَرَدْنَا تَحَسُّنًا, if they want to lead It tests life. They come to Ardal Hayati Dunya. You want to get some worldly rewards for that? Some worldly wealth? وَمَنْ يُكْرِهُنَّ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ مِنْ بَعْدِ إِكْرَاهِنَّ غُفُرُ الرَّحِيمِ Whosoever compels them, then surely Allah is after their compulsion, forgiving and merciful. Allah will not hold that girl, slave girl, as a culprit, because she has been forced to do it by her master. وَلَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ آيَاتِ مُبَيِّنَاتِ And we have sent down to you إِلَيْكُمْ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ Very clear, illuminating revelations. وَمَثَلًا مِنَ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ And we have given you the descriptions of those people who were before you. وَمَوْعِظَةً لِلْمُتَّقِينَ And the exhortation for those who are God-fearing. اللَّهُ نُورُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ Now, the most important ayah of this surah. Rather, one of the most important ayat of the whole of Quran. A simile for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu nuru samawati wal ard. Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth. What does it mean? Just as we need light to see each other, to see this world, we can't see. You might have, the sight is here, it's okay. But you can't see without light. In the same way, the hidden realities of this universe, which we call metaphysical realities of this world, they cannot be understood except you know Allah first. You believe Him first, then only you will be able to know all the hidden and metaphysical realities of this universe and existence. Allahu Nur Samawati wal Ard, Masalu Nurihi, the similitude of His light, is this, كَمِشْكَاتٍ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٍ There is a niche in the wall, and there is a lamp in the niche. أَلْمِصْبَاحُ فِي زُجَاجَةٍ And the lamp is in a glass. أَلْزُجَاجَةُ كَأَنَّهَا كَوْكَبٌ دُرِّيٌ And that glass appears as if it was a shining star. يُوْقَتُ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ And this lamp, you know, is burnt, lighted. From the oil of a shajaratin mubarakatin, a very blessed tree. And that is the tree of zaitun, olive. La sharqiyatin wala gharbiyah. Which belongs to neither the eastern part nor the western part. Now this, you know, olive tree, which is standing alone. Full day, the heat of sun and rays of sun are playing on it. If some tree is towards the east of some big wood collection of trees, then in the morning it will get the rays of the sun, but not in the evening. It will be under the shadow. If it is towards the west, then in the morning it will not be able to get the sunshine, and the solar energy it won't be able to absorb, but it will be only available in the evening. But a solitary tree standing alone, it has all the day absorbed the solar energy in it. لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء Now the oil of such a tree is so clear, so clear. يكاد زيتها يضيء that it is ready to glow. لو لم تمسس النار although fire had not touched it. Now we can understand this, the difference. We had kerosene oil or mustard oil. In lamps we used to use them. But they don't catch fire themselves. You have to have some cotton root weed, put it here, then through that cotton weed it will burn, and then you will get the light. But what about petrol? It is as if it catches fire, although you have not brought the fire to it. It itself advances forward and catches fire. So this is the simile which is being used here. There are certain people, the oil of their nature is so nascent, so pure, that they are as if awaiting for the call of the Prophet of Allah to respond to it immediately. We read the ayah in Surah Al Imran. رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا مُنَادِيًا يُنَادِي لِلْإِيمَانِ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِرَبِّكُمْ فَآمَنَّا And we have the example of Abu Bakr Siddiq, the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to anyone, to all to whom I presented my da'wah, they took some time to understand, except Abu Bakr. He didn't wait even for a second. Why? You know, the oil of his nature, which was burning already in his heart. Now you know, this our chest, the ribs, they are just like the niche in the wall. Then there's the heart. It's like a lamp placed in that niche. And you know, it is shining. But this shining, this noor, is not like this noor. This is the internal light of the faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Noorun ala noor. When the fire touches it, now it is noor over noor, light over light. One was the light of the pure nature within the man, other is the light of the revelation. When they join together, well, this is Iman, 100% Iman, the strongest Iman. Noorun ala noor. Yadillahu li noorihi man yasha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides to his light whomsoever he wishes. وَيَضْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْأَمْثَالَ لِلنَّاسِ. And Allah strikes these similitudes for the people. وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. This is the necessity for the human beings. They can't grasp these subtle realities. So they need some similitudes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he strikes the similitudes for the people. Whereas he knows everything as it is. Just as there was a prayer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allahumma arini haqiqat al-ashya'i kama hiya. Oh Allah, show me the reality of things as they are really, not as they appear. The apparent is visible to the animals also. The dog has also seen that the car is coming and it is saving itself. If you have also seen so, what's the difference? But that inner light, seeing by the heart, hearing by the heart, pondering over through heart, through your ruh, that is something else. Fi buyutin, now this light in the persons, where will you find it? Where to find it? The most important place are the houses of Allah. Because they love the houses of Allah. They want to spend maximum time in the houses of Allah. Fi buyutin azin Allahu an turfa'a wa yuskara fi asmuhu. In those houses about whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded that it should be raised and his name should be remembered over there. Bil ghudubi wal asal. In the mornings and in the evenings. Rijalun la tulhihim tijaratun wala bay'un. They are those men whom neither the trade nor any particular bargain stops from the remembrance of Allah and establishing the prayer. Now first, for example, let us suppose a shopkeeper was sitting from the morning. No customer came. And when a customer enters the shop, there is the call for azan also. Now he is being tested. If he attends to the customer, that means he has attached more importance to this worldly gain. رِجَالٌ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ. Those men who cannot be prevented by any trading or any particular bargain from the remembrance of Allah and glorifying Him and establishing Salah and giving the obligatory zakah. يَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا. Even after doing all this, they keep fearing, they keep trembling about that day, تَتَقَلَّبُ فِيهِ الْقُلُوبَ وَالْأَبْصَارِ, in which the sights and the hearts will be overturned. إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. We have already read. So they tremble at the thought of that day. أَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. لِيَجْزِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا. So that Allah should reward them, recompense them with the best of what they did. وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. And He should add to the reward from His bounty. The reward is to be calculated according to their deeds. But from His bounty He can give anything, as much as He likes. There's no need of reckoning or any arithmetic or mathematics. وَاللَّهُ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives and provides whosoever He will without any reckoning. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include us among those. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.